We've all seen this glowing lines effect, made famous by Blotter Media. And there's been plenty of tutorials on how this can be done in Final Cut Pro by using a dedicated plugin. There's a couple of problems with this. One is these plugins can be expensive and really bog down your computer. And two is you have to use a trackpad or a mouse to make these animations, which can be tricky and take forever. Today, I'm going to show you how you can do this exact same effect much easier and faster, and without having to buy a special plugin by using an iPad, an Apple Pencil, and ProCreate. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and welcome back to my channel. Let's jump right into Final Cut Pro and get started. First thing we need to do is select a range in our timeline where we want to apply this effect. Skim your timeline, and with a skimmer a few frames before where you want this effect to start, press M on your keyboard to add a marker. Without moving the skimmer, press I to set an endpoint. Move your skimmer to where you want this animation to end, and press O to set the out point. Selecting a range allows us to export just a specific part of our timeline instead of our entire project. Hit the share button, select your export preset, and export the selected range from your timeline. Airdrop this exported file to your iPad. Open up ProCreate, and in the top right corner, tap on Photo to open up your Photos library. Select the clip you just exported from Final Cut Pro, and click Use to import this video clip as an image sequence into ProCreate. Tap the brush selection tool, and pick the type of brush you want to use for this effect. The one I like to use is called Light Pen, and you can find it in the Luminance category. Select it, and tap on it one more time to open up Brush Preferences. To make your brush strokes nice and smooth, select Stabilization, set the stabilization amount to about 50, and Motion Filtering to about 20. Also, to make sure your strokes are a consistent width, select Apple Pencil, and set the pressure size to 0. Select your brush color and the size of your brush, and tap on the first frame where you want to start your animation. We now have to animate our clip frame by frame. We'll start out with just a couple lines at the bottom and make them move up. Move to your next frame and redraw your lines from before, and this time extend them out a bit further. Select the next frame and extend your lines out even more. We'll keep going until our first animation is complete, then reverse the order to animate our lines out. And because each frame will only be visible for a fraction of a second in our finished video, these lines don't have to be perfect. Honestly, if the placement changes slightly from frame to frame, in my opinion, it just makes the finished result look better. Let's scroll back to the start of the sequence and tap play to see what this looks like. Repeat these steps for the rest of your clip, adding as few or as many animations as you want. Having to do this frame by frame does take time, but trust me, this is way faster than trying to do it with a mouse or a trackpad. Once you're done, go back to your gallery, hit the share button, and select either animated MP4 or the animated HEVC format to export this as a video clip. Select max resolution to retain your video quality, make sure the frame rate matches your original clip, and hit the export button in the top right corner. Airdrop this file back to your Mac and import it into Final Cut Pro. Add this clip above your timeline, making sure to line up the start of this clip with the marker you set earlier for this cool effect. If you enjoyed this video and you haven't yet, make sure to check out the rest of my channel for more tutorials just like this one. New videos uploaded every week, so please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.